Dear State Secretary Master, dear hosts and participants throughout Europe and around the world, it is a great pleasure for me to open the second edition of the Digital Education Hackathon. This is one of the flagship initiatives in the field of digital education, and this is a key part of our Digital Education Action Plan. The recognition that this hackathon has received is well deserved. It promotes core European values and stimulates innovation, cooperation, and co-creation to define the future of education in the digital age. My special thanks go to the European Institute of Innovation and Technology, and in particular to the EIT Climate Kick for leading the initiative, and to Aalto University for coordinating it. Of course, I would like to thank the German Presidency of the Council of the European Union for hosting the main stage event, and the national partners from the Forum for Digitalization in Higher Education, the German Academic Exchange students, and Technical University Berlin for organizing it. The user-driven innovation promoted by the Digital Education Hackathon creates new ideas and helps us meet the challenges posed by COVID-19 pandemic to the education and training systems. There is a saying that in the midst of every crisis lies an opportunity. I see a lot of creativity and determination in the fast and adequate way in which many teachers, students, and educational institutions have adapted. We should learn from this experience and seize the opportunity to continue to modernize our education systems and strengthen their resilience. The idea of rapid and agile innovation is powerful. All of you, you have participated in hackathons before know it. So I invite you to take this drive, to combine it with teamwork and creativity, and to use it. You can look for solutions together by taking full advantage of the different backgrounds, experiences, and perspectives of the participants. Through the Digital Education Hackathon, we want to find solutions. We turn to you, students, teachers, education and training staff, research institutes, innovation hubs. And we are not only looking for technical solutions, such as apps or platforms, but also for innovative and creative ideas which can be put into practice to improve education in Europe and beyond. Innovators, of course, need recognition. Therefore, all local winning solutions put forward through the hackathon will be assessed and evaluated. A global award will allow the three winning teams to gain visibility at European level and receive 5,000 euros to start implementing their ideas. During the first edition last year, 33 local hackathons took place in 21 countries. This year, we have more than doubled this number. We have more than 70 hackathons in 34 countries. Events are taking place from Cyprus to Argentina, from Ireland to Nigeria, making this a truly global community. Last year's winning teams from Spain, Italy, and Mexico showed how different in context, but similar in nature, are the challenges around the world. You will hear about their experience a bit later. This year, the hackathon is fully digital, allowing even greater exchange across borders and time zones. We have a wide variety of hosts, from ministries of education, schools, universities, and teacher training centers to edtech companies. We also have a wide variety of challenges, from disinformation to robotics, STEM, and sustainability. And today, we do need innovative solutions. The pandemic has clearly shown that our education and training systems have a long way to go to be truly ready for the digital age. From a recent consultation, we learned that COVID-19 pandemic amplified existing inequalities in education and training, and that digital skills and competencies have become even more important. 95% of the respondents consider that the current crisis will have a long-term impact on how technology is used in education. Reflecting these findings, the new Digital Education Action Plan, which I presented on 30th of September, outlines an ambitious vision for high quality, innovative and inclusive digital education that promotes European values. The action plan will support member states' efforts through two strategic priorities. First, we need a high-performing digital education ecosystem. It means adequate infrastructure, connectivity, digital equipment, and institutional digital readiness. We'll support this through digital transformation plans for all types of educational institutions, from primary to adult education, to help teachers develop digital skills and confidently use innovative pedagogies. We'll launch a self-assessment tool for teachers and Erasmus teachers' academies. Secondly, we need to improve the digital competencies and skills of all citizens, regardless of their age and background. Being digitally literate is a must. The development of basic digital skills should start at an early age. We should also strive for a good level of advanced digital skills to strengthen the digital talent pool and stimulate innovation. Boosting successful actions such as the digital opportunity traineeships will be key in this process. And this brings me to another key topic for today. I'm delighted to launch here and now the 2020 edition of the Education and Training Monitor. The Monitor is the Commission's flagship annual publication on education and training in the European Union. For 9 years in a row, the Monitor provides in-depth analysis of how the European Union is performing on the common key targets. This year's Monitor highlights progress in reducing early school leaving and increasing participation in all education sectors, from early childhood to tertiary education. Nevertheless, the Monitor points out the persistent challenge of equipping all young people with basic skills. Around 20% of 15 years old is not demonstrating a sufficient level of competence in reading, maths, and science to participate fully in society. And this year's lead team is teaching and learning in a digital way age. This was planned long before the pandemic, but it could not have been timelier. On this topic, I would like to emphasize that contrary to the commonly held view that today's young people are a generation of digital natives, the Monitor indicates that young people do not develop sufficient digital skills just by growing up using digital devices. This does not mean that our pupils' digital skills are not improving. They are, but they need to be further developed. The Monitor also indicates that teachers were not adequately prepared to use digital technologies in the classroom before the crisis. On average in the European Union, fewer than half of teachers, 49%, report that ICT was included in their formal education or training. Yet the role of teachers in this endeavor is key, and the Monitor provides us with interesting insights concerning the digital readiness of teachers and, most importantly, how it translates into teaching practices. I will stop here, but I warmly invite you to follow the dedicated technical session on the Monitor tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, in the last few months, it has become clear that in Europe, we share a lot of similar challenges and opportunities when it comes to digital education. Many discussions have taken place at European level, and we have seen how much we can learn from each other, especially in difficult times that require European solidarity. To build on this and increase cooperation in the field of digital education between member states at European level, we'll launch a European Digital Education Hub. This will respond to the call for enhanced cooperation and exchange of good practices and models for digital education. In the short term, the Digital Education Hub will provide a platform for bringing together national stakeholders involved in digital education. In the long run, we would like it to serve as a platform to discuss the future of education in the digital age. And the hackathon will contribute to the objectives of the hub by encouraging stakeholder engagement and user-driven innovation. Dear Digital Education Hackathon community, the future of education in the digital age depends on all of us. We can achieve our common goals of high quality, inclusive, and accessible education and training if we work together. I'm sure many of your ideas will inspire us on how to make education truly ready for the digital transformation. The time for action is now. I wish good luck to all of you. Use your creativity and open your imagination to new horizons. I look forward now to answering your questions. Thank you very much.